Good morning. My name is the Militant Negro, and this is my YouTube network. I want to welcome you in. Wish you a happy holidays, whether you celebrate Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever. And I want to talk about a few subjects this morning. I'm first going to start off with the Republicans and their plan to gut Social Security and raise the retirement age. Now, this is something that the GOP has wanted to do for years. But I guess now that President-elect Donald Trump is going to take office on January 20th, they put this plan in motion. What is very important for everybody to understand about this privatizing of Social Security or cutting Social Security benefits or raising the retirement age is that this affects every single American citizen. It doesn't just affect the Democrats or the liberals or the progressives or the independent. It also affects Republicans, conservatives, right-wingers, alt-right people. This affects everybody who is disabled, who is of that age to be receiving Social Security. It affects people, period. So nobody, no matter what your political affiliation is, should be in favor of this. Social Security, and I've said this so many times till I'm almost purple in the face, Social Security is not broke. It's solvent through the year 2076, according to the Bureau of Social Security. Now, it's also a retirement plan, a fund, whatever you want to label Social Security. It's funded by the very people who work every single day, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days a week, 8 hours plus a week, 365 days a year. It's funded by those people who work and are paying into it. So how can it be broke? How in the holy fuck can politicians, congressmen and senators be so focused on fucking with Social Security and Medicare? That's another thing they plan to privatize and gut and cut just so they can line their own pockets with more cash. Social Security is working just fine as it is. It does not need to be fucked with. Okay, that's the first thing I want to say. Leave Social Security the fuck alone. Why don't you asswipes concentrate on creating jobs, putting people back to work so they don't have to mess with unemployment or get early retirement or bother with their Social Security benefits before they should need to. That should be your focus. My next thing that I want to discuss is Ray Lewis and Jim Brown met with Donald Trump. So did Kanye West, but Kanye's a little bit touched in the head. He's a few nails short of a full deck, as I like to say. So it doesn't really concern me or interest me that Kanye West met with Donald Trump. But Jim Brown and Ray Lewis met with Donald Trump. And there have been a lot of questions asked. Is this a good thing? Should Negroes meet with the president-elect? And my response to that is pretty simple. Barack Obama has been president for 8 years. I don't see him one time meeting with a group of concerned people of color about anything of significance. Donald Trump is not even the president yet. He hasn't been sworn in. And he's been meeting with any and everybody who wants to see him. Business leaders, financial leaders, people from the Negro community. He's sitting down with Donald Trump and Ray Lewis and discussing matters of economic stability for the Negro community. When has Barack Obama done this? Besides a photo op. I'm talking about serious sit-down conversations. Jim Brown ain't no punk. Even at the age that he is right now today, he is not a punk ass. I can't say the same for Ray Lewis. He's a coon. He's a house coon. But this is a positive thing that he did with Mr. Jim Brown, whom I highly respect. Jim Brown was standing up for people of color and their rights back when it was not something you did and remained alive. So I respect Jim Brown. And if Jim Brown took Ray Lewis with him, then there's a certain amount of respect that is due Ray Lewis, even though in the past, he's been a house coon. But people are concerned that these two Negroes met with President-elect Donald Trump. And my question is, why are you people hating on Donald Trump reaching out to people of the Negro community? Hate is a powerful thing. These two gentlemen met with President-elect Donald Trump to discuss economic issues that face the Negro community. Where is the harm or wrong in that? People need to get over this partisan bullshit politics. If Donald Trump is going to help people in America, who cares what his political affiliation is? Who gives a shit what he said pre-election? It's what he does post-election that matters. People are tripping on who he picks for his cabinet. Newsflash, idiots. It's his cabinet. He's the president-elect. He has every right to choose whom he pleases, as did Barack Hussein Obama in 2008. I can't stress that enough. It's his right. He gets to choose who the hell he wants. You don't like it? Move to another country. I'm tired of saying this. President-elect Donald Trump has not even spent 1 hour in office as the president. And all these people are having conniption fits about every little thing he does, from picking his cabinet to wiping his ass. Wake up, people. There are more important things going on in this world than what Donald Trump is doing before he even gets sworn in. Sick of this crap from people. I have blocked and walked away from friendships I have online with idiots who are bloggers, who are Twitter followers, Facebook followers, because they will not allow me to have the same rights that they have. They don't like Donald Trump. I don't like Donald Trump. But it's my choice as a free Negro man to choose who I want to support. And I support the President of the United States until he fucks up. I supported Barack Obama until he fucked up. I support Donald Trump as President-elect until he fucks up. When he fucks up, if he fucks up, I will be all over Donald Trump's shit like white on rice, like stink on shit. That's how it's done. You don't prejudge. You don't criticize before there's anything to criticize about. You don't like Donald Trump's picks for his cabinet? Why? You can't judge what a man is going to do by what a man has done. This is a whole new ball game for all these people who are being picked to be in Donald Trump's cabinet. His staffers, all these individuals Donald Trump is surrounding himself with, this is a new gig for them. They will be held to a different standard than anything they've done or said before. I trust that the President of the United States, along with his staff and those people who are really pulling the strings behind the President of the United States, the real people in power, those elitist, wealthy Caucasians will keep things going like they've been going for the past centuries. Nothing has changed. Nothing has ever changed with any president. Everything is the same. People think the Democrats and the Republicans are different. They are not. They are the same. They are one political organization running America. You haven't figured that out yet? You are asleep. And that's the problem. You people don't wake up and research and educate yourselves. You don't investigate anything. You listen to all this fake news, fear-mongering bullshit that's going on. You listen to the mainstream media who needs to sell ad space. And the best way to sell ad space is to get viewers to tune in to what you're saying. Read what you write. And you can't do that if everything is happy and copacetic and joy in the sky shit. You need confusion. You need division. You need complications. You need problems. You need war in order for people to be interested enough to buy your newspapers, read your online magazines, watch your news shows. Nobody's tuning in if everything is perfect. The media likes turmoil and chaos, and that is what they are creating at this very moment. So people need to wake up and focus on what needs to be focused on. I'm out of here. Namaskar. Happy holidays.
Talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky ghetto. Trying to survive. Trying to stay alive.